Hello children, once again welcome to our biology class, class 9. Now till yesterday we learnt about cell, its structure and function. Cell being the structural and functional unit of life. Now in the first lesson when I told you that the plant cells are different from animal cells. Plant cells are different from animal cells. If plant cells are different from animal cells, obviously we need to know more about the plant cells and more about animal cells differently. We cannot get confused. Now, a group of similarly functioning cells, what do we call? We call them as plant tissues. We call them as tissues. Tissues are a group of similarly functioning cells. Tissues are a group of similarly functioning cells. The study of tissues is called histology. The study of tissues is called histology. And histology. Study of tissues is called histology. And who made a major contribution in the field of histology is Nehemiah Group. He wrote particularly in plant tissues today. So first we learnt about tissues. Now we are going to learn in this particular lesson about plant tissues as a separate lesson. What is our lesson name? Plant tissues. Plants are all not like tissues in plants are different from tissues in animals. Why is it like that? If you notice, plants are those living organisms which continuously show growth. Continuously keep dividing, continuously growing, continuously there is a cycle of things going on happening in plants. When it comes to animals, it is more complex than plants. Plants, though they are continuously growing, the complexity when compared to animals is less. They are simpler. Their life processes are simpler. Except for the most important topic, that is photosynthesis. The remaining are all easy for understanding, and the complexity is not as much as in animals, even in multicellular plants also. As a single cell, we understood that each single cell performs certain functions, many functions. But certain cells in certain parts, they function much more differently, capably one particular function. For example, when we learnt about the cells, we understand that photosynthesis, it needs sunlight. That means which part of a leaf is concentratedly doing the photosynthetic activity. If you notice a leaf, the upper part of the leaf is always darker in color and lower part is lighter in color. It means that the upper part is receiving more sunlight. That's why more of the chlorophyll is like accumulated there, resulting in the dark color of this leaf. It means that that particular part is performing more photosynthesis. Now, in stem is also sometimes green in color. When it is green in color, it means that it is also performing photosynthesis. Does it mean that it is performing so much of photosynthesis when compared to the leaves? No. And what majorly it is doing? It is helping the conduction of water and food. It is helping in conducting the water and food. Water from roots to the rest of the parts of the plant, and food from leaves to rest of the parts of the plant. So like that, a different part of the plant is performing different function. That means some cells in particular area are performing a function differently, more capably. So all these things we are going to learn in our present lesson. Tissues, what we understood is a group of similarly functioning cells is called tissues and study of tissues is called histology. The scientist who made major contribution towards understanding of this is Nehemia Grew. If you try to know more about him, he wrote a book, actually four books, complete everything related to anatomy of plants he mentioned in his book. That's why he became very popular. Every question has been answered in his four books which he wrote on plants and their tissues, anatomy of plants. If you ever get a chance, you go through that. So now let us see. Every part of the plant has a different function to perform. So what are those functions? If you observe the textbook, there is an activity mentioned there. They are asking you to find out what does absorption of water from soil. Function is absorption of water from soil. All this you know already. Exchange of gases. Exchange of gases. Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. And then transpiration and then reproduction. Transpiration and then reproduction. Let us see. Absorption of water from soil. Which part of the plant is doing this? Root, or we can call root hairs. Root or root hairs. And then exchange of gases is done by stomata. Where is the stomata present? At the underside of the leaf. Photosynthesis is performed in the leaf. Majorly the places where chlorophyll is mostly prominent. Transpiration is again done by stomata, which is present on the underside of the leaf. And reproduction is through flowers. Flowers, fruit, or seed. Flower, fruit, or seed. So all these functions are done by different parts of the plant. This is what we are going to learn in our present lesson. Before we go into the present lesson, let us see. This is activity 1. This is activity 1. Let's go to activity 2, which you already learnt in. This is activity 1. I expect you to fill this in your textbook, children. Now, coming to activity 2. These activities will help you to understand the lesson thoroughly. What is activity 2 is onion peel. You will observe onion peel cells. Take an onion, open it and then tear it reverse side. You get a translucent layer. Translucent layer. Then put it on a drop of water. Drop of water on a clean slide. With the help of a brush, because it easily gets torn, that's why. And then remove any folds. Remove any folds. Add a drop of saffronin or methylene blue or red ink also will do. Drop of saffronin and then cover it with a cover slip. Cover it with a cover slip. How should you cover it? Very carefully, without air bubbles in that. And then remove excess water. Remove excess water. Observe it under the microscope. Observe it under the microscope. Now, what do you observe? You observe the cells The cells are like this. They are very neatly arranged. Longitudinal cells. And then a nucleus is also noticed. So this is the arrangement of a cell. And what do you prominently see here is nucleus. You prominently see here nucleus. Now suppose you observe, let me say this is activity 3. This is onion peel. Remember children, onion peel. This is how the cellular arrangement is. Now coming to the third activity, same thing, everything will be the same except that you don't add safranin. We don't want that color. Now imagine you take a beetle leaf, tamalapaku, and then all of a sudden tear it like this. And then if you tear the beetle leaf, it will be like this. The ridges, the serrated ridges it has. And then when you tear it like that, imagine when you tear it like that, you will find a thin layer here like this. A thin layer is noticed when you suddenly tear. Can you notice the thin layer like that? Very delicate layer that you have to take before it gets, you know, dried up in the atmosphere. You put it on a drop of water, and if any folds are there, remove it. And then it is on a drop of water. Now cover it with a cover slip, carefully avoiding any air bubbles, and then remove the excess water. Here what are you doing? You are not adding safranin. And then you will understand why I am saying that. Here because you added safranin, it is looking pink colored. Okay. You don't notice. Okay, I will explain to you. Now observe it under the microscope. What do you observe? You observe cellular arrangement like that. And then by seeing this diagram, you should have understood what I am trying to tell you now. Beetle leaf, no? That we took beetle leaf. Leaf means what? What will it have? I hope you understood what I am trying to show you. Compulsory nucleus will be there in every cell. But other than nucleus, what is there extra in this beetle leaf is this. It has stomata. So why we didn't add safranin here? Because we don't want the safranin to discolor the green color. It is looking green in color. Now let us observe what are the differences. This is a transparent layer. Here you notice nucleus, you notice everything elongated and not that closely packed, relaxedly arranged cells you notice, and you don't notice stomata. But here because pink is added, it is pink in color. It's not because the onion peel is pink in color. It is colorless actually. But here it is green in color. You didn't add any kind of stain to this. It is green in color and the cells are closely packed and it has stomata in that, and nucleus is clearly noticed, chloroplast is clearly noticed. That is the difference between onion peel and green leaf, beetle leaf. Beetle leaf is green in color because it is producing food. That means it is performing the function of a photosynthesis. What is onion doing? Onion is not performing photosynthesis. That's why you don't get any kind of green onions anytime. So with this, we understand the difference between the onion peel and the green leaf. Next, we will learn in the fourth activity, we learn about furthermore about our plant cells. Thank you.